What?
Boy, I don't think they're ready for this.
These moves looking real nice in the future. These moves looking real nice in the future. These moves looking real nice in the future. Pull up on them and it look nice. Look nice.
These moves looking real nice in the future. These moves looking real nice in the future. These moves looking real nice in the future. Pull up on them and it look nice.
Yeah, we look nice. Future looking nice. We don't need to tell them twice.
Here comes the future.
Yeah, we look nice. Future looking real nice. We don't need to tell them twice.
Here comes the future.
MacArthur Bulls versus Wellington Phoenix, the sixth and final match of this opening round of the new Isuzu A-League men's season for 2021-22. We've had a look at 10 of the sides that are starting out in this campaign, and now this final match, a chance to get a first look at the Bulls and the Phoenix. Plenty of new faces, plenty of departures, and players ready to fill those boots. As our two sides make their way out onto the field of play, we're going to have a look at the starting lineup for Ante Milicic's side, for Ufuk Tale's Wellington Phoenix. This match that was, of course, meant to be played at Campbelltown. The Bulls so desperate to make the most of any hometown advantage this year, unfortunately scuppered in the last 48 hours. We're going to have a look at Ante Milicic's starting 11 now for the MacArthur Bulls. Plenty of changes during the off-season for this side that made the semi-finals, finishing sixth. Six of the new signings are in the starting 11, starting in goal with Filip Kurto, the Polish shot stopper. And of course, the number 10, Ulysses Davila, the former Wellington man. While for Wellington, Ufuk Tale, for him, it's mostly departing players. A few new faces and a few returning ones as well, in the form of Gary Hooper, wearing the number 88 shirt. And up front will be one of the big goal threats for Wellington this evening. The final match of round one of the Isuzu Ute A-League men's season is underway. MacArthur and Wellington Phoenix. And Daniel McBreen joining me in the hot seat, like it's been all weekend. Just so keen to have a look at these two sides, see how they're going to line up and see what they can provide for the rest of this season.
Yeah, that's right, Robbie. It's as we said, it's a tale of two tapes with these teams. One very young with a few older heads in there, but the other team with lots of experience in MacArthur. It'll be interesting to see how this plays out.
And we can see immediately a first little surprise there for MacArthur, because it's three at the back, three central defenders, so a change in formation. For Ante Milicic's side, we can see Meredith on this left wing, and it looks like it's Craig Noon then, the new signing from City, and the player that created more goal-scoring chances than any other player last season in the A-League men's competition, playing on a right wing-back role is Meredith with Da Silva. He's another new player to have arrived at MacArthur Bulls. A big switch of play from Jordan Much, another of the new faces. There are six of them, and of course a familiar face in Davila, the Mexican. He finds Noon. Well, if goal scoring was a problem considering all the possession they had last season, surely with this Arsenal up front that shouldn't be the same problem, or at least there'll be no excuses this time. Yeah. Now here's David Ball for Phoenix, their first real attack, and the cross in, and that's some save. Brilliant reflex save. And Gary Hooper, who's only just returned to Phoenix, his second stint after scoring eight goals in 21 in his first season with the Phoenix, can consider himself rather unlucky perhaps not to have another one there.
Both teams very well organised so far in defence.
Much caught in possession but gets it back. Now Hooper, well played with Wayne. Now a little bit of space. Piscopo, ooh, now he's had his foot taken out of him, just on the edge of the area. Ball thinks it's a penalty, and we might have another look. You think so too, perhaps?
I think his first contact with the foot, I thought on first glance, was inside the box, and he's fallen outside, but obviously we'll have to see the replay.
If there was contact inside, he'd be the first striker in the world to fall outside the box.
I just thought his left foot here, we'll have a look. He goes inside the, well, it's his right foot actually, and that is inside
that
the
is
box.
Inside.
And that's a penalty.
And we can hear it. Well spotted, Macca as well.
Yep.
It's Meredith, the left back, with the foul, and we know that Renato Piscopo has been earmarked, and there's plenty of weight on his shoulders as well. He's got the number 10 that he inherited from Uli Davila. They want him with his dribbling skills to cause problems, and there's no doubt about it now when you see the replay. It's in the box and it's a penalty. And Phoenix, after that chance to Gary Hooper, after just 8 minutes, they're going to have the second best chance of this match as well, despite playing without the football and playing in their own half for much of this match so far.
Yeah, I'll be honest, I actually thought Piscopo made the wrong decision when he turned back inside. He had a great overlapping run from the outside, but good quick feet and a rash challenge, just clipping the foot.
That's going to be ball to take Ohupa. It is. Looking for a goal-scoring return, and it is for Gary Hooper, the 33-year-old, back after a spell in India, returning to the Phoenix and straight back onto the score sheet as well. Wellington 1, MacArthur Bulls 0, 25 minutes in. We spoke about Phoenix's slow start last season. It was the same for the MacArthur Bulls, without a win in their first three games, and Ante Milicic didn't panic, stuck with the same players, stuck with the system, and it bore fruit in the end as well. He's such an experienced coach, even if this is, we say, his first real head coach of a club side. He's seen it all before. Here comes MacArthur, overlapping run. That's a good ball from De Silva for Noon, and he can't get the cross in, so desperate to cross on that left foot. Uzcock. The effort from distance, but always going well wide of the mark there. Oh, De Silva's been caught by Rufa there. And the referee, I think, is he going to get out the yellow card? He is. First booking of the contest, 34th minute. And it's probably a deserved yellow card, I think, because I think the arm was raised into the back of the head of Danny De Silva as well. In the last few minutes even, it's Wellington that have wrestled back control of the possession stakes as well. Meredith was in there. So too Jovanovic. The shot blocked and Lewis gets it clear for Phoenix. One for Piscopo to chase. Curto coming a long way. Sweeper keeper of their 3 points as it stands at the moment. Here comes Davila looking to change all that. Twisting and turning, so tricky, and the ball in, and again it's just half a yard too high for Lockie Rose in the middle as Mombwa is pinned for the foul.
It's the first time we've seen Davila really find some space in that forward third. It's a little bit of trickery on the ball. Just like to see MacArthur players get in around Lockie Rose in the box, get some more numbers in there, give him another target to hit.
Well, it's so hard to pick out your target in the box with a cross. Crossing statistics always look pretty negative. Oh, as there's a bit of trouble here. Benjamin Wayne not happy, that challenge from Uzcock. And it really drew the ire of the Wellington Phoenix players. The challenge on David Ball.
Well, David Ball, he just takes a look over the shoulder and he sees him coming, and I think Uzcock realised, I've misjudged this, so I can't let you get past, I'm out of position, and it's a cynical challenge.
And I am a bit of a, have a soft spot for stats, even if I know that they can be misleading. Wellington Phoenix were the most accurate crosses of a football last season. We saw one great ball in for Hooper early on. But MacArthur were the most prolific crosses of the football. But you need numbers in, that was the point. If you're getting so many balls in, if that's your game plan, you can't be aiming for just one player. As the shot there from Piscopo again, showing that he is a danger, just drifts across the face of Curto's goal. All of a sudden, in the last 10 minutes or so, it's been MacArthur who have been looking to transition quickly forward, with De Silva, Davila carrying the ball forward. Here's Meredith now. That's nicely done. Well played, Much. Finding De Silva. Whose shot always rising over the crossbar and not coming down, but well worth a ping from that kind of distance as well.
Yeah, it was neat play. James Meredith playing in, taking the decoy run on the outside. Ball came back inside to De Silva. And as we spoke about in these conditions, take your touch.
Can that change now? Jordan Much. Sushnya with Meredith again. De Silva. Sushnya, and it has to happen now. If it's going to happen, De Villa, he can produce something out of nothing. Mombwa. This is well played again, well constructed by MacArthur. Noon's ball into the back post. And Meredith just couldn't get on the end of it, could he?
No, it was lovely play. Worked through the middle with De Villa. Mombwa on the ball. Noon with the cross. Meredith, good to see him getting in there to support, but not quite getting on the end.
Excellent first half of football here at McDonald Jones Stadium. MacArthur, 0, Wellington, Phoenix, 1, but plenty more action still to come. You get the feeling this one is very evenly poised. And there we go. We are back underway. MacArthur, the home side, trailing by a goal to nil. Gary Hooper's penalty in the 25th minute. The difference between the two sides, and just about the only difference between the two sides, isn't it, Macca? Because it's been an even first half, just a little bit more cutting edge. Often coaches talk about taking your chances in both penalty boxes, and that's been the case for Phoenix.
Yeah, it was a wonderfully executed penalty, but I think Phoenix, you know, had that chance in the 8th minute, which was a wonderful save from Curdo. I think we all thought that was going in the back of the net. They've just created the slightly better chances. Just need to see a little bit more urgency from MacArthur to get players in the box. Lockley.
Sushnya coming forward, 25 yards out from goal, and he's continued his run as well. So now they do have numbers forward, and Noon's ball in towards Lockie Rose. Good defensive header, Jordan Much, and MacArthur. Look like they have decided to try and play a good 20 yards higher up the pitch now. Meredith, his ball in. Noon attacking it at the back post. McGarry's header away. And they come again. Sushnya. Meredith with De Silva. This is where they have to keep momentum going. You can see Wellington Phoenix have numbers back. De Villa's ball in towards Rose. Woozcock. Clever little pass. Now that one's going to fall off the back of the pack towards Craig Noon, who does well, gets their head of ball back in. And again, you feel a little bit for Lockie Rose, don't you? Because everything's just flying over his head, every ball in at the moment.
Yeah, he's working hard. He's working hard in the middle against two or three players.
Played again, Meredith for De Silva. De Villa peeling off the front line, looking for a bit of space. Finds it now. Plenty of respect from the Phoenix players as well for De Villa. Standing back, they know he's dangerous one-on-one. They'd almost prefer to let him pass the ball away than get in too close and be eliminated one-on-one. Here he is again. Oh, that's a clever pass for Meredith. And it's well defended again. Roofer that time.
And it's those two again. Meredith on the left and De Villa now getting involved. Nice interplay. Little reverse pass from De Villa here. That's a lovely little pass. And Meredith just takes the touch. Gives the opportunity for Rufa to slide in and make the challenge.
Plenty of words in the box. Jovanovic involved. Here it comes again. It's a good ball. And MacArthur thought for a moment there between Jovanovic and Meredith that they might have had the equaliser. Lockie Rose's ball in, back post again. Meredith climbing all over the back of his opposite number. Ball it was, making a nuisance of himself, doing just enough. Now De Silva, pressure from MacArthur. Free header that time for Ruzcock. They come again, Lockie Rose. It's a good touch, and again it's well defended this time by McGarry. It's only early days as well as Davila's ball in back post. Meredith's header. And the save by Oliver Sale, and by my reckoning, the first save of the match for Ollie Sale. Well, we've spoken about a lot this weekend, how it's going to take time for these sides to bed in. MacArthur are another one that it's they've got plenty of new players as Phoenix come forward. Here's ball received from Hooper. Ball still going, and the shot across the face of goal. It was a good half chance for the away side again. So a double change, Orr and Najjar into the game, and it will almost certainly mean more numbers forward as well. Davila. Davila shot deflected wide. You can see immediately Najjar, Orr, De Silva, Davila. It's a positive from Ante Milicic.
Yeah, it is. And Najjar's a player that likes to get forward as well.
There's no Tommy Juric, of course, for MacArthur. Their new signing from Adelaide. As the ball comes in for March, and he climbed well at the near post and just couldn't get over it and get it down under the crossbar. And they've got men to deliver the ball as well now in Deliver and Noon. Davila, clever little touch. Well, that's a lovely ball. De Silva back for Davila. It might yet fall. The ball ricocheting around. And now March straight into the hands of Oliver Sale. Only as far as Tommy Orr now. Noon again. There was going to be no way through there. Oh, but Phoenix, all of a sudden, having said how solid they were looking, are starting to look a little bit nervy. Noon's ball back post. Najjar is there. Lockie Rose as well. Davila. And now March again. Deflected and just wide. Ball back post, and they have their equaliser now. The corner in, and Lockie Rose gets his second ever A-League goal. And more importantly, draws MacArthur level. After netting a couple in the cup 10 days ago, we were saying how he barely had a sighting on goal. One opportunity presents itself, and the youngster drives it home. MacArthur 1, Wellington 1.
Found himself in that great area at the back post.
No, that's well defended by James McGarry.
And he's done that well tonight, James McGarry.
Stood up well. Oh, now is that flag going to go up for offside against Wayne? Sotirio driving into the middle. Oof, a huge collision in the box, but everyone's back to their feet very quickly by Philip Curto. And now they fall to the ground. Oh, well, he's got a bit of blood, doesn't he, under that eye. Is it the eye?
Yeah, I think
it looked as though it was almost the ball or a boot.
Yeah, it looks like he's just got a little cut under the eye. Yeah. The player's calling for the doctor, but he's motioning he's okay. As we see here, he comes out very brave, down at the feet. Two players. There you go.
There it is, the boot.
Yeah.
From Sushnyar.
Sushnyar's boot, but that's brave goalkeeping. You've got to be special to be able to do that. Throw your head down. People coming in with their boots.
Try and get back into this contest. David Ball, two on him. As he looks inside towards Josh Sotirio. Rufa. Free kick's gone Phoenix's way.
Well, Liam Rose has just been booked after coming on.
And that looks quite painful, doesn't it? Clayton Lewis. A couple of dummy runs, a couple of hesitations. Now it comes in near post. It's not a bad delivery, just a little bit too close to Philip Curto.
Yeah, it had a good shape on it. Just crept away from the oncoming players, though.
And on a wet pitch as well. We haven't seen the dreaded cramp so far. But there's still plenty of time for that. 11 minutes left. Ball's ball back post. A little nod down. This might be the chance. Surely it will be. Oh, it's been cleared by Uskok. Incredible piece of defending. Desperate stuff. Phoenix almost somehow found themselves back in front. And now they have to be very careful. The quick counter-attack. Davila's pass just didn't have enough on it to release De Silva. Villa with a rare heavy touch gives the ball away. Lewis, ball, good awareness, good vision, good shot. And just over the crossbar. Wellington Phoenix, MacArthur did their hard part in what was an excellent start to the second half. And now both sides have 5 minutes left plus stoppages to try and find a winner. We've had a couple of good contests over this weekend, Macca, as well, between Western United and Victory, which was a hard-fought, even contest. This one, like that one, has come to life in the second half.
Reminds me a little of the old Doors song, LA Woman, but he's worked really hard.
Davila.
David Hall doing his best rugby league impression there, wasn't it?
But hasn't he worked hard as well?
He has.
I mean, if he'd scored at the other end, it would have been almost too much for a player that's that's worked that hard, that's defended so much as well, that's gotten forward. And in a young side, it's great to see one of the experienced players.
Leading by example.
Absolutely. Yep. De Silva. Ball in, back post. The header. It was won by Sushnyar. And it's just taken a glance off a Wellington player, apparently, according to the referee. And he's the man that counts in this situation. Ben Abraham hasn't had a bad game otherwise, the referee.
No.
Let it play.
Yeah, let it flow.
Back in. No shot. Is there the header? It might yet fall, it might yet break. One over the top, and Wayne has done well. And here's ball again, and ball saved by Curto. Well, again, he's popping up in the right place, still full of running. And it's another great chance for Phoenix, and they have had their chances, haven't they?
You see here, thought he might have taken it first time, but took the touch, got it out of his feet, had to really dig it out from underneath him.
Outside for Wayne. No flag. Sotirio's in the middle. Old is sauntering up the back post. Oh, and the cross is poor in the end.
It was a great run from Wayne. And Sotirio was in the middle, but I think Wayne was looking and seeing Sotirio in an offside position, so he couldn't play the ball across. He was waiting for him to get back onside. And in the end, looked to bend it to the far stick for the second runner. Just couldn't find the target.
Sotirio has won the free kick there. And there's going to be one last chance, and it's not going to go the way of the home side. We have just over 30 seconds left. Ufuk Tale knows this is match point for Wellington Phoenix. Clayton Lewis, that left foot to deliver. Plenty of numbers forward. In it comes. Ooh, and it was all Wellington.
Well, a flurry of corners as the full-time whistle's blown.
It ends 1-1, but only just. Both sides had their chances in what was an intriguing match of football here at McDonald's Jones Stadium. MacArthur Bulls 1, Wellington Phoenix 1.